Hello, and welcome to an overview of the Ignition Data Center demo. This demo is meant to represent a project that provides real-time status and historical insights into a single-site data center. This first screen is the main overview, which displays major site-level KPIs at a glance. Starting from the left side of the screen, the first two-thirds of the overview is used to show 9 site-level KPIs, depicting values like cooling capacity, power usage effectiveness, and IT load. Each KPI's real-time value is indicated in a moving analog indicator component and a label below the indicator. The blue band within the indicator provides visual context for the normal value range for each KPI, providing at-a-glance insight as to when values are above or below normal. In addition to the real-time value, historical information for each KPI is shown in 2 spark lines, representing the most recent 24-hour, 7-day, or 30-day historical values. A minimum, maximum, and average value is also displayed for each historical range. Combining the real-time status value in the moving analog indicator and the dual time range historical trends, we are able to provide powerful at-a-glance insight into the current state of the major KPIs and what their values have looked like over the past day and week. On the right side of the overview, we also display the site's composite performance index in a gauge to show the site's overall performance. Below the composite performance index, the data hall performance grade indicates the overall performance of the subsections of the 2 main data halls, so end users can see at a high level whether each section is performing optimally. Lastly, on the far right side of the screen, we have some general site KPIs, including location, temperatures, and alarm aggregation. The next main screen is the floor plan of the data center. This screen provides a top-down depiction of the entire data center with its 2 main data halls and their respective 4 sections. In each section, we can see the individual server rows. This floor plan screen provides a lot of insights both at a glance with the 2 main data hall KPI sections on the far left and far right of the screen, and with drill down insights for specific equipment on the floor plan itself. Every blue or green item in the floor plan represents a particular piece of equipment. Hovering over a particular piece of equipment will display the equipment name in a tooltip. We can then click on the equipment we want to drill down to, bringing up a custom faceplate that displays critical information relative to that piece of equipment. Faceplates are included for the switchgear, UPSs, AHUs, and PDUs. Now let's take a look at the EPMS single line screen. This single line in particular depicts one of the 8 data hall sections in the demo. This single line was created as an SVG and then imported into Ignition, so any single line diagram that you might have, even potentially depicting an entire site or data hall, could be brought into Ignition in the same way. A great feature of this screen is our ability to implement pan zoom functionality, so regardless of how simple or complex your diagram is, you can always zoom in to a particular subset of the diagram to get the insights that you need. Ignition components have been overlaid on the SVG1 line to provide real-time status indicators for the equipment like the breakers and power quality meters. The breakers, power quality meters, XFR, UPSs, PDUs, and standby generator are all clickable, which will bring up equipment faceplates to provide more details on the equipment. Here we have the BMS heat map. This screen depicts a single section of hot and cold server aisles, providing a visual heat map with 3 sensor values for each aisle. At the bottom of the screen, there's a historical playback feature, which allows us to go back and look at the recent history of the heat map for that section, along with any alarms that may have been active at the selected time. This demo also includes a dedicated screen for Ignition alarms, depicting current alarm status and alarm history with Ignition's alarm status table and alarm journal table components. In addition, there's a dedicated screen for ad hoc trending with Ignition's power table component. Here, we can designate important tags to trend by default, but also ad hoc any historized tag in the data center for further insights. Here we have an architecture screen depicting a multi-gateway architecture that could represent a small-scale site, including 2 front-end servers and a back-end server with redundancy, connected to a database and several edge devices. Lastly, we have a scenarios page that steps through 5 theoretical states to show how to improve the optimization of a data center. A few items of note as we wrap up this video on the data center demo. In the top right of the demo, there is an icon to view alarms, as well as a settings menu to change the theme of the project. Also, with the Power of Ignition's perspective module, we're able to make this entire demo completely mobile responsive. So this same demo could be displayed on a 75-inch TV, used on a desktop like we've shown here, opened on a tablet, or even a phone with zero configuration changes. Such is the power of Ignition. Thank you for watching this video and learning more about Ignition's data center demo. If you want to explore this demo more or leverage any parts of it for your next project, it's available for download for free on the Ignition Exchange. Thank you.